गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू दिस चैप्टर मैन्युफैक्चरिंग इंडस्ट्री एज वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड दिस चैप्टर इन द प्रीवियस मॉड्यूल। टुडे विल डिस्कस सम मोर टॉपिक्स फ्रॉम दिस चैप्टर। लेट अस सी वन बाय वन। इंडस्ट्री मार्केट लिंकेज। हाउ द इंडस्ट्री एंड मार्केट इंटरलिंक टुगेदर। यू कैन सी इन दिस डायग्राम that inputs like raw material and other component parts, factors of production, land, labor, capital, entrepreneur, infrastructure are connected to this factory through transport. And this factory, whatever output comes from the factory, that again go through the transport in the market. And all these are interlinked through money. So this is the money which is linking all these different stages of industry. So this way you can understand here how the industry and market interlink together. In the previous module we have discussed ki how that industries are located, how the producer takes decision while setting up their industries. So here an ideal condition is shown ki how the producer takes decision and what is the main idea in the mind of that producer. The key to decision of the factory location is the least cost. So this least cost, the minimum cost, is the main idea in the mind of the producer while taking decision for locating, for establishing any industry. So here, ideal location of an industry can be the cost of obtaining raw material at a site. That cost of obtaining raw material should be the minimum. The cost of distribution of production also should be here. Before this cost of distribution, cost of production at a site should be minimum. As the cost of production will be minimum, then only the profit margin can be maximized due to tough competition in the market. And cost of distribution of production. So how that goods will reach to the market, what will be the transportation cost and other thing, so that also is playing key role while taking decision to locate the industry at a site. So all these three factors are very properly thought by the producer while taking decision to locate industry at a site. Classification of industries. Here industries are classified on different basis, like on the basis of source of raw material. Though already these you have studied in your earlier classes, like in class 8. Though on the basis of source of raw material used, industries are classified in agro-based and mineral-based industries. Agro-based industries are those industries which are getting their raw material from the agriculture, like cotton, woolen, jute, silk, textile, rubber and sugar, tea, coffee, edible oil. These all comes from the agriculture. Mineral-based industries are that industry which are using minerals as input in their industry, like iron and steel, cement, aluminium, machine tools, petrochemicals, etc. According to their main role, the basic or key industries and consumer industries, these two are there. Basic or key industries are those which supply their production as raw materials to manufacture other goods, example iron and steel and copper smelting, aluminium smelting, etc. Consumer industries that produce goods for direct use by consumers, means that are ready to use, like sugar, toothpaste, paper, sewing machine, fans, etc. Now, on the basis of capital investment, industries are classified in small scale industry and large scale industry. So, small scale industries is defined with reference to the minimum investment allowed on the asset of a unit. So, this is defined with reference to maximum investment. That maximum investment is rupees 1 crore. So, this limit changed over a period of time. At present, maximum investment allowed is rupees 1 crore. A large scale industry where the capital investment is more than 1 crore, then it is called large scale industry. Example, iron and steel industry, automobile industry, etc. So, in this way, on the basis of capital investment, industries are classified in two categories, that a small scale industry and a large scale industry. And both the decisions are on the basis of money invested. Less than 1 crore, small scale industry. More than 1 crore, large scale industry. On the basis of ownership. On the basis of ownership, industries are classified in four categories: public sector public sector, private sector, joint sector, and cooperative sector industries. So, public sector industries owned and operated by government agencies like BHEL, SAIL, Bharat Heavy Electrical Limited, Steel Authority of India Limited, etc. Private sector industries owned and operated by individuals or a group of individuals like TISCO, Tata Iron Steel Corporation, Bajaj Auto Limited, Dabur Industries. So, these are private industries owned by individuals. Joint sector industries, which are jointly run by state and individual or a group of individuals. Here, the state and individual both can be involved, or group of individuals are running that industry. Oil India Limited is jointly owned by public and private sector industry. Here in this region, NCL is also such kind of industry, joint sector industry, where the central government and some private individuals are involved, like Reliance industry and some more are attached with this central government. Cooperative sector industries are owned and operated by the producer or supplier of raw material, workers or both. Here, cooperative sector is jointly owned and operated by the producers and or a suppliers ऑफ रॉ मटेरियल, वर्कर्स बोथ. मीन्स इन कोऑपरेटिव इंडस्ट्री द कॉन्सेप्ट इज देयर, हूएवर आर वर्किंग इन द इंडस्ट्री दैट ऑल आर ओनिंग द इंडस्ट्री एंड दे पूल इन द रिसोर्सेज, शेयर द बेनिफिट्स, प्रॉफिट्स और लॉसेस प्रोपोर्शनेटली. सच एग्जाम्पल्स आर सुगर इंडस्ट्री इन महाराष्ट्र, द क्वायर इंडस्ट्री इन केरला, अमूल इज अ वेल नोन इंडस्ट्री. बेस्ड ऑन द बल्क एंड वेट ऑफ रॉ मटेरियल द एंड फिनिश्ड गुड्स, हैवी इंडस्ट्रीज सच एज आयरन एंड स्टील इंडस्ट्री एंड लाइट इंडस्ट्रीज that use light raw materials and produce light goods such as electrical good industries. Let us discuss in detail about agro-based industries. In agro-based industry, mainly we think about the cotton, jute, silk, woolen, textiles, sugar and edible oil, etc. industries are based on agricultural raw material. Textile industry. So, it is related to the cotton and jute industries. So, textile industry. The textile industry occupies unique position in the Indian economy, because it contributes significantly to industrial production, employment generation and foreign exchange. One more important point is, it is the only industry in the country which is self-reliant. Self-reliant means each and everything is getting from itself and complete in the value chain, as here diagram is shown downside, from raw materials to the highest value added product, as here given that fiber production, the agricultural production of cotton, jute, whichever is done, silk, woolen. So all these production done by the farmer. Then spinning. Again here, the people will be spinning that thing. Weaving. Weaving done here only. Dyeing and finishing can be here. Garment manufacture. Here garment manufacture and dyeing and finishing interlink together, because sometime after garment manufacture, dyeing is done, finishing is given. So interlink here shown. Fiber production is a raw fiber. The spinning is done in yarn, that you can understand by this thread. You see dhaga dekhe honge. Weaving, knitting of that fabric, knitting, you understand that the cloth material is produced by weaving. Cotton textiles. In ancient India, cotton textiles were produced with hand spinning and handloom weaving techniques. And the first successful textile mill was established in Mumbai in 1854. After the 18th century, power loom came into use. Our traditional industries suffered a setback during the colonial period. This colonial period, you know that the British period in India, because they could not compete with the mill-made cloth from England. Means the our traditional industries in India suffered during that colonial period, because you know that industrialization started in Britain, that is London only. So their industries were much advanced that time only. So that way our producer could not compete with them. In the early years, the cotton textile industry was concentrated in cotton growing belt of Maharashtra and Gujarat. Availability of raw cotton market, transport including accessible port facility, labor, moist climate, etc. contributed toward its location. So these were the points important because of the location of industries in that Maharashtra and Gujarat. You know that cotton needs a moist climate, and this moist climate helps in better quality yarn, production of better quality yarn. And the fiber is also, this cotton fiber is also produced in that region of better quality. So that is why these industries were set up in that region only. This industry has close link with agriculture and provide a living to farmers. Cotton ball pluckers, the workers engaged in ginning. Ginning, you know that it is a process of separating the fiber. Just combing, you can understand that fibers are combed so that their thread means their fiber should be separate from each other, and while making the thread or while spinning, the proper good quality yarn can be created. Then spinning, that after this process ginning, that spinning is done, and after spinning, weaving. Of course, when the threads are ready, the cloth can be prepared by weaving. And this dyeing work sometime done just after spinning and sometime here after weaving. Designing. So next stage comes designing, packaging, tailoring and sewing. All these workers get job opportunities in these different fields. So you can see here how a huge level of employment opportunities can be generated or being generated. So the industry, by creating demands, support many other industries such as chemical and dyes, packaging materials and engineering works. So these industries also get support from the textile industry. While spinning continues to be centralized in Maharashtra, Gujarat and Tamil Nadu, weaving is highly decentralized to provide a scope for incorporating traditional silk and designs of weaving in cotton, silk, zari, embroidery. As weaving can be done all over the country and government also supported to the people, so this way weaving can be seen all over the country spread, not centralized this is, and that way it is using the traditional skill and design of weaving of the people. Because of that many qualities, still there is some problem. So that problem is ki why is it important for us to improve our weaving sector instead of exporting yarn in large quantities? So that let us discuss ki why this question is put here. In your textbook also it is given this question. India has world-class production in spinning, but weaving supplies low quality of fabric, as it cannot use much of the high quality yarn produced in the country. Means the weaving sector of our country is not developed as the spinning sector. As India is producing world-class spinning spindles or yarn, you can say. Weaving is done by hand loom, power loom and in mills. But that is not looking sufficient. The hand-spun khadi provide large-scale employment to the weavers in their homes as a cottage industry. India export yarn to Japan. Even though these facilities are there, means the power loom, hand loom, mills, all are working in our country. Even though India export yarn to Japan, some other importer of cotton goods from India are USA, UK, Russia, France, East European countries, Nepal, Singapore, Sri Lanka and African countries. And most of these countries, if they are importing from our country, so that are maximum the yarn, not the garment and other part of this textile industry. So we have a large share in world trade of cotton yarn. Our spinning mills are competitive at the global level and capable of using all the fiber we produce. But the weaving, knitting and processing unit cannot use much of high quality yarn that is produced in the country. This is the big problem of our country. There are some large and modern factories in these segments, but most of the production is in fragmented small units which cater to the local market only. Means what quality they are producing not getting demand in the world market, so they are able to somehow supply their produce to the local market only. This mismatch is a major drawback for the industry. As a result, many of our spinners export cotton yarn, while apparel and garment manufacturers have to import fabric. In our country only, the garment producers not purchasing the cloth material produced in our country, they are importing from other country. Even the other country are using the yarn from our country only. So this way you can see here that yarn is sold at 85 rupees per kg, and if it is sold as a trouser, it fetch 800 rupees per kg. So the value is added at every stage from fiber to yarn to fabric and to garment. So that way you can see how much value addition is taking place. And if we are selling from our country, exporting this yarn, Then how much we are in loss? 85 to 800 per kg. This difference is showing around 10 times we are in loss. So although we have made significant increase in the production of good quality long staple cotton, the need to import is still felt. Though we are producing that cotton, but still we are importing the cotton up to some extent. Power supply is erratic and machinery needs to be upgraded in the weaving and processing sector in particular. Other problems are the low output of labor, as it is a well-known fact to all of us in our country that output of labor is lower than many of the Asian countries. And stiff competition with the synthetic fiber is there. Because of this also, we are facing some problem. Here in this map, you can see the cotton textile industries centralized in this Gujarat and Maharashtra, and some here seen in West Bengal, and that all you can see near the coastal region. From the colonial period, this trend started due to the export from our country. Very less here, as this is the Gangetic Plain region, most fertile land in the world, we can say. Cotton textile is not good produced here. Woolen textile are spread in these few states only. Silk textile also looking in this Jammu and Kashmir region. Then here, West Bengal, rest here looking in Karnataka and Andhra Pradesh region. This is all about student. Thank you for today. Please revise all this topic in the book thoroughly and write important points as notes. Thank you. Have a nice day.